Today, I'm going to be showing you how to do a Viking-inspired warrior hairstyle just in time for Halloween. Before we start, I need to give credit where credit is due. The person who did my hair for this and the person who found a creative way to do this style that I showed her with my insane hair transplant, hair loss situation hair is a girl named Maddie at Lavender Blondie. If you've been here for a while, you've probably seen her in one of my other videos. If you haven't seen that video, go watch that video next because Maddie is freaking hilarious. But beyond being an absolutely sensational, incredibly talented technical hairstylist, she's also an amazing person. Maddie's been with me through my hair loss journey. She's been with me through my transplant journey. She's found creative ways to hide my hair loss by adding extensions, by doing all these different things. She's found creative ways to hide my transplant stuff. She truly is a hair genius and a hair superstar and my absolute hair bestie. I love her so, so much. So thank you so much, Maddie, for creating this hairstyle on me and for just being like an amazing human being. The first thing that you're gonna do is section your hair out from temple to temple and clip that out of the way. Now you're gonna section the hair and do two tiny cornrows on the sides of your head. A cornrow is just a teeny tiny Dutch braid, so don't let it overwhelm you. If you know how to do a Dutch braid, you know how to cornrow. If you want a tutorial on how to do a Dutch braid or how to cornrow, leave it in the comments and I'll make a tutorial for you guys to explain it even further. After each Dutch braid, Maddie secured the end of them with these tiny elastics that you can get at the dollar store. Now is when we start with the hair extensions. What Maddie did was spray some texture spray and dust some texture powder on the root where you're attaching the hair extension, back comb that root, and then attach the extension there. You're gonna do this moving up the head all the way to the crown area in the middle section where you didn't cornrow. After those extensions were installed, she took a crimper and she crimped everything. The extensions, my hair, everything. What this did was create like a really Viking textured look. This is an essential step. This is not something you want to skip. You're not going to get the same type of disheveled look if you don't crimp. This is literally what makes it look super badass and authentic. When Maddie was done crimping, she took the entire temple to temple section and did a Dutch braid, which is again a cornrow, but much bigger. This time, instead of leaving it really tight like the cornrow, she started pulling the braid out. And as she did that, she created like a really huge, puffy, like big effect, almost like a faux hawk in the middle of my head. This is done in two ways. It's done because the cornrow or the Dutch braid is being pulled out and fanned, but it's also done because of the actual crimping. The crimping is making it look big as well. When Maddie got to the ponytail section, because I have really short hair and it's also very fine because of the transplant, she gave it more volume and length by wrapping extensions around the ponytail and clipping and bobby pinning them in. To hide the weft, she took some of those extensions from the ponytail and wrapped it around the base of the ponytail. And then she went over every piece again with the micro crimper and gave it that really texture, lived in, kind of rustic vibe. And here is the end result. All right, The reason that I did this warrior inspired look is because this photographer named Jen Linfield, who's located in the Waterloo-Kitchener region in Ontario, she reached out to me and she had heard about my alopecia story. We had never met before. She had this vision of this warrior, you know, this feminine warrior kind of standing up against their own insecurities, their own flaws. And so when she reached out to me for this idea, I was totally down for it, but also a bit nervous because just like everyone else, I have my insecurities and hair loss definitely, although I'm open about it and I feel like it's really important for me to share this story and connect with women who are going through it. It does definitely make me feel really insecure. So showing them off was, it kind of freaked me out, you know, at the beginning when I was thinking about the idea. I wasn't 100% sure I wanted to do it, but then I started to really think about it, and being a woman and being able to kind of show our flaws without this stigma of, you know, insane insecurity and without letting it define or beat us up is something that I felt really strongly about. You know, after I've created this channel, I've realized that, like, no matter who you are in the world, no matter where you're from, we all have our things. We all have our physical things, our emotional things, our psychological things. And these flaws can be ones that define us, that we hide from, that we don't accept, or they can be ones that lift us up, that connect us, and that allow us to grow a stronger, more warrior style woman. So my hair loss journey kind of started off as something that felt really stigmatizing for me, that I hid from everyone, that no one knew about. And when I came out with it, it became something that connected me, that allowed me to talk to you guys, that allowed me to be a part of your lives and allowed me to, you know that I'm not alone and for you to know that you're not alone. So this whole experience was really, really cool. It was cool to say a big F you to my hair loss, to wear it proudly as like a war wound, as something that has defined my life but not represented my life. And so I hope that you take some inspiration out of that, to let your flaws shine, to own them, and to, you know, let them fly away from you. Don't let them have such a heavy weight on your heart and on your mind. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you want some more clarity on this tutorial, you want to know some really specific details on how to make a Dutch braid or how to make a cornrow, definitely leave it in the comment section. I always read those comments. I'm really, really focused on making this channel something that is going to help you and something that you find value in. I'll see you in a few days. Bye.